see. If you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you.
I've heard up there the streets are made of gold,
and when you get there, there's a hand to hold.
I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you.
The streets are made of gold,
and when you get there, there's a hand to hold.
I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Thank you.
there's a place up there for people like us, up there for people like you.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. Streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place with people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. When your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. Your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Observe the protocols of the COVID restrictions. Hence, we want to properly social distance. We want to ensure we have a number of persons inside. We want to sanitize as much as is possible. We want to bear in mind that this is a Thanksgiving service. The first part of the entire process. In a while we'll be starting, we won't be doing a procession. We will be just starting from the podium here. So as I watch, crowd, I'm going to ask the musicians to give me a soft interlude of music, and in the next minute we will be starting, when I will just ask you to engage us together. Could we all stand, please? Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. God is a refuge and strength, a very present help in the time of trouble. Who can find a virtuous woman, for her price is far above rubies? Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own words praise her in the gates. Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. With that, I want us to turn our attention to the program. You have one. We'll be singing the first hymn, our opening hymn, Sing the Wondrous Love of Jesus. We're asking the musicians to just do your best to engage us in worship as we sing this song together. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercies and his grace. In those mansions, bright and blessed, he'll be there for us a place. And we all get to heaven. What a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will say, and shall there be glory. While we walk, there will be smile, as we know the way.
Father, come before your presence this morning. We for your grace and for your mercy, dear God. Oh, Father, as we are here, God, celebrating the life of, oh God, giving thanks for the life of our dear sister who has departed us. Oh, God, we ask you to just be with us this morning, oh God. Let your Holy Spirit walk amongst us, oh God. I pray you wrap us in that comforting spirit that you have, oh Father God. And I pray that the spirit of unity will stand with us all this morning, oh God. I pray you lift us up. I lift up that spirit within us, oh Father, so that we can still, oh God, bless your holy name and give you thanks for all that you have done for us and all that you're doing for us this morning. Walk with us, oh God. Guide and protect us. Cover us under your blood, oh Father God, and grant us strength as we go forward in your name. I pray, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. I want to thank you very much, Lay Minister Ben, for praying. You can be seated, congregation. At this juncture, I'd like to express my sincere condolences on behalf of my family's church family and self to the bereaved family of our late sister, our late sister, Olive. Well, I learned recently that her name is Gloria. Such a great name. I want to express my sincere condolences to the family, brief family members. This morning who are here with us. We just want to know that the Lord will give you the comfort you deserve. We pray that God will undergird you with strength and the ability to cope, to bear your loss in this time. We know it is not an easy time for you. It's very difficult. But we trust in a God who is able to give the kind of comfort that you really, really need. We ask God to enable you, to have you go on, live your life despite the loss. It's not an easy time, and words are never always adequate to express it. But when we say it, I want to feel that we say it from our heart. Because we ourselves have known the pain you bear. We have known the person you're missing. We are acquainted with the person that is gone. We know of her value, her service, and everything else. So we likewise are grieving with you this morning. Not though with a hope, with a perfect understanding of God's word, that she was one that has hope in God and lived her life as a Christian. Hence, there is another life to come. And we trust and hope in the new life we'll meet her again. So may God undergird thee with strength that you will be able to go through. That being said, I want to recognize some persons who are here with us. If I can be just right on this, I hope I can do a good job. With me on the rostrum is the host pastor, Pastor Balda Bennett, who is the host pastor of this church, and also Minister Iris Robinson on my left, Deacon Byron Myrie sitting down in the floor here. We also have already indicate the members of the bereaved family, how many are here, not sure, but I trust and hope that there are sisters, brothers, nieces, nephews, cousins, and other relatives. I know daughter Camille is here, son-in-law, Mr. Allen is here, granddaughter, they are sitting in the front here. And outside we have Mr. Allen, Mr. Bobsy Allen. We also recognize the presence of Mr. Delapena, who is the employee to Ms. Camille Allen, and also taking care of this funeral arrangement to an extent. We also have other persons. I don't know if not another minister is here. We have Lay Minister Kwame Ben. Who could I forget it? We also have a person from the community, friends, mourners all, maybe from near and far. We recognize you this morning in supporting this family today. And we trust that your support will give them the strength to help them grieve and make some closure to the loss that they now bear. We also hope that your support today will be the tower of strength to them. In whatever area you may play a part or what you have to do on this program, I hope you can do your part and do it well. Gloria Hutchinson, sunrise October 17 and sunset September 4, 2021. She was one of those persons who we come to know for some time, serving God and serving her fellow man of humanity in her life with the part she tried to play. This morning we're here because of her death and her passing then. And we trust that as we come together for this memorial service, which I should indicate to you, which will be in two parts, by 12 o'clock or so, we will be doing the next part, which we want to observe the protocols that is set for us to do. So we are having a memorial service here. And the next part, we will take it to the next level, which will be the internment. But in this order, we want to proceed and carry out the functions as we should. Pastor Bennett is very much down in spirit, I'm sure, and the rest of members of this church. This was where she had spent a great part of her life serving the Lord and doing all that she can to advance the kingdom of God. But I hope that she can get the strength enough to carry on some years of this program today. I know it's not easy. So in all my remarks, I just want to also, despite we've been somber, to have a cheerful spirit in this endeavor. We believe. Can I say we believe collectively here? And include everyone that has faith in God? That despite the loss, and she's absent in body, she's present with the Lord. Can we conclude that there's hope in God to say, we miss her. We lost her to the grave. But thank God, there's an everlasting hope that burns in our heart to say that she is not gone forever. As people in some of the eastern countries would say. Amen. We are not of that kind of faith. We have a firm belief, hallelujah, and a confidence in God. As Jesus says, that your brother, your sister, your mother will live again. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. I don't reach to message yet, but I just feel inclined to stir your pure minds in this order. Oh, bless God. The first reading lesson will be from St. John 14, verse 1 to 3. And it will be done by Janie Allen. Janie Allen, granddaughter. Could somebody help her with the mic? Okay, Bible is there. You can use the microphone down. Sure. And those who do the sanitizing, could you stay a little nearer for me, please? When you're ready. Thank you.
Good morning. The Bible lesson is taken from John 14, verses 1 to 3. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believeth in God, believeth also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, that ye may be also. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen. The next verse will be here with that of Pastor Valda Bennett. And we want you to pray for her so that she will carry on.
It's a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. I must greet Bishop Bennett, Minister Rob, Deacon Myrie, other ministers and well-wishers that are in the crowd this morning. I greet you well. It's a challenging moment for me, but if I sit back and don't do it, I know I would not be doing her justice. So I just ask you to pray for my strength. And so Bishop Bennett have not known the children, so I'm going to ask, Sister Sinclair is here. I've been just appointed as minister, and your brother. So let me see the children, the three children for Sister Olive. Okay, put your hands together for them. Thank you. And the grandchildren. Yes. Thank you very much. And I heard so much about her brother. I would really want to see him. Okay. I will talk to you after. Thank you very much. I want to say this morning in my short remarks is that we have missed Sister Olive, lost her to the grave. But as I was saying to Sister Camille this morning, God could have prevented it, but he allowed it to happen for a reason. But we don't know the reason. And honestly, when the song was singing, I really couldn't manage it. I have to walk out. But I want to say, Camille and Andrew, her daughter, her brother, they have done their best. And when I say Camille have done her best, who live with her, and Andrew, I live closely to the family, and they have done their best. And some person might have different concept, but Camille, when she was leaving to the hospital, she said, Pastor, I'll be taking her to Hardgraves Hospital. I can't take my mother to the Mandeville Hospital. And she have been with her, and Andrew never leave her side. Never leave her side. And I want to say to them this morning, be strong and of a good courage. I know the Lord will give you this grace to go through. And Andrew, you stand up like a man. And God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. And to the only brother, I tell you, I heard so much. And I want to say thank you for doing your best towards my cousin. I thank you very, very. When the call comes, you reach Mandeville before Camille reach, and you're coming from Maypen. That showed me how much you loved her. St. Catherine, and you reach there. And I want to say thank you very, very, very much. Not many siblings would have done this, but I thank you, and I owe it to you, because you have tried to let my cousin stay alive. And everyone else, Sister Sinclair have done her part, but you don't live with Sister Olive, so you have to understand, and her brother. So I have to speak about persons who live with her, that they have done their best. Every pain she feels, she called me. Every pain Sister Ali feels, she called the phone. And I want to say, if prayer could save her, she would be here today. The church family missed her. We really, really missed her. She's head cook and bottle washer when it comes to church. Sister Ali is in everything. Once there's a function, I don't have to talk to her two times. I just said there's a function. Sister Olive is here to clean up the place, to let the place fresh, let everything be done decently. Sister Olive is in if I have cookout, Sister Olive is in the kitchen first. And then it's here I have to call Auntie Dawn. But he makes sure she's in the kitchen first. And I want to say, we really miss a friend, a sister, and a family. But I thank you, Mr. Allen and Mrs. Allen. You stood beside them. And I want to say thank you. And may God bless you. Jenny is her heartbeat. The last breath she take is what with Jenny on her mind. and she spoke about her. But the Lord will give you the strength, Janae. You make her proud. When you pass your exam to the country, she called me and she started to cry. Pastor Janae passed her exam and she started to bawl. So I think you make her proud before you exit this life. Thank you very much. We're going to continue with the program and we'll be having a remembrance from the church. It should be done by Sister Nerys Copeland, but she have online class because she's a teacher, so she could not make it today. So Sister Morley, Minister Moore, is going to do the remembrance for the church, followed by tribute, after that by the said Sister Moore. All right, so then we go to the second lesson, which will be done by Cadian Anderson, granddaughter-in-law. Put your hands together for Sister Moore.
Remembrance for the late Gloria Olive Hutchinson, Sister Olive. As a member of the Church of God of Prophecy, Cross Keys, I remember our dear Sister Gloria Hutchinson with joy. She was affectionately called Sister Olive by us all. She was a phenomenal woman who loves the Lord and encourages others to do the same. She was a very hard worker who worked in many different offices in the church. Sister Olive worked as an usher. She took this job very serious, and every visitor that comes through our church doors would receive a welcoming smile and encouraged to come again. She was in charge of the beautification of the church along with other sisters, and she took pride in the appearance of the church. Evidence of this is still present today, as the flower pots here now were made by her. Sister Olive showed her love for the Lord in many ways. She served in the women's ministry department for years as a booster. An active member of the church choir, she also worked in the ABM department as an assistant care group leader. Sister Olive was a true missionary who would tell of the love of the Lord wherever she went, as you would always find her inviting young people to come to church and to give their hearts to the Lord. She would also visit the sick and pray for them. Having looked at the things I remember about our dear sister, she was like the head cook and bottle washer. If we were to plan and prepare an event, she would be fully involved. She would be the first at the church to start preparation. My fondest memory of Sister Olive was her passion for the upkeep of our pastor. She loved her dearly, and it showed by her treatment of her. And as such, she was a member of the pastor's aid committee, which spearheads all the events that caters to showing appreciation of our pastor. Sister Olive was indeed a faithful steward who would tirelessly in the service of the Lord. Who worked tirelessly in the service of the Lord. She was extremely active on our Zoom platform for Bible studies. She even got her daughter, Sister Sinclair, to join us online and participate by sharing the word of the Lord with us. As a church family, we miss our dear Sister Olive's beautiful smile and soft voice. Our consolation as a family is that Sister Olive Hutchinson died in the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 4:13-14. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brethren, about those who are asleep, so that you will not grieve as do the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep in Jesus. So children, grandchildren, and other relatives of our dear beloved sister Gloria Olive Hutchinson, we grieve her passing with you today, but we also rejoice in the hope that we will meet her again. Sleep on, Sister Olive. Take your rest, and light perpetually shine upon you. Bless the Lord. I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days have been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up, you have been so
the Lord. Could we worship the Lord? Come on, could you wave your hand and worship the Lord? If the goodness of the Lord is running after you, just worship Him. You know why I chose this song? 1 week before she died, she didn't know she was going to die. She kept singing this song every day. And she called me and said, Pastor, I love this song, you see? And she keeps singing this song for me. And so I chose this song today to celebrate her life. Praise the Lord. Let's continue with the program. Camille, not supposed to cry. Please give her some water for me. And the doctor advised her not to cry. Please, somebody help her for me. We're going to continue with the program with the next lesson that will be taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 from verse 13 to 14. It will be read by Cadian Anderson, granddaughter-in-law, and the tribute from Mr. Roy Hutchinson, brother. And we go in that form.
From 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 14. Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve at the rest of mankind who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in Him. Thank you. This is speaking of God's holy word, God, I pray, thanks be to God.
Good morning, church. First, I have to greet my wife right here, Mrs. Hutchinson, my sister, all executive members, friends, family. The position that I stand here today, I didn't know that I would be standing here. But when I think of the goodness of Jesus and what He has done for my sister, my soul cry out, hallelujah. Hallelujah to you, Jesus, for saving my sister. So we have to give God thanks and we have to praise God, because we were all born in sin. And when God saved us, we have to give Him all the praise. You know, today, my sister, Alice, she's the first grandchild for the Hutchinson and Gregory family. First, she's my first born from my mother and father. Five of us. My other sister is right here, Pauline. Most people here are supposed to know her. My sister, when our mother died, I was just 6+. She was about 11. She cooked. She cared for me. She feed me. My God, man. Every call my sister call on me, I have to answer. Because I remember the thing that she have done for me. She treat me more than a brother. She feed me. When somebody feed you, you know, a good thing, you know. Yeah, man's a good thing. Small brother, 6-year-old, you can imagine that you lose a mother at the age of 6 and your bigger sibling stand up for you. Eh? What a wonderful sister she is. Everywhere my sister lives. Everywhere my sister lives, I go to visit her. We never leave one another. We're so tightly knit. We talk since the phone thing come in. Technology. Every day we talk on the phone. We message one another in the morning. And sometimes we have a little devotion. And she always encouraged me as a small brother to stay faithful. And I encourage her the same thing, just to stay faithful. And I lost a sister, a friend. And we all lost a friend, a grandmother. A grandmother, a friend. When I got the message from Camille that my sister had passed, you know, I tell her for days I couldn't eat. The first night I get about 2 hours sleep. But I am still giving God thanks. I am still giving God thanks because I am here. I am here today that I could stand and in the gap of my sister. So I am just giving God thanks. She's gone. But I think she's present with the Lord. She's just absent today, you know. And, you know, but we still have to give God thanks. Because look, 3 siblings, grandchildren, brothers, sister, friend, it impacts somebody's life. Yes. So we still I am giving God thanks because I am a believer and I have hope. So all I have to do now is just continue in the path. So one day I hope to see her. That is my take for today.
Thank you very much, Uncle Roy. Thank you very much for remembering your sister in that special way. I hope Sister Hines will forgive me. I missed out Sister Hines. You know what? This glass and this thing and this mask just hide our identity. But it's when Uncle Roy said, Sister over, I said, Lord, Sister Hines, I know you forgive me because you have a forgiving heart. All right? Thank you very much, Sister. At this time, we're going to change the atmosphere and we're going to have some medley of choruses at this time. Before we have the tribute from Life in Abundance and Alice, Sister Alice and Brother Joseph, they are going to come after Life in Abundance. So we are going to change the atmosphere at this time because Sister Olive loves choruses. She loves choruses. And so we're going to give her her wish. All right, thank you.
Praise the Lord. Let me hear you worship the Lord. Worship the Lord. Worship the Lord. Praise the Lord. My dear sister, praise God. She loved to dance in church. When you see her worshiping, bless the name of Jesus, it is as if there is not another day. It's her last day. So she'll be worshiping. She give it her all. Bless the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Oh, what singing. Oh, what shouting. On that happy morning when
Savior in the sky, redemption coming.
start to dance, and then we have to follow her. Amen? And I would love this one again. If you would give me In the Rock I Hide. She loved this one. And come, Sister Morris. Okay, you know, Pastor don't have any voice. All right, we're going to sing Sister Moore, Lay Minister Moore. Right, let us sing. Let everybody stand. And let us worship the Lord.
In the Rock I Hide. Come on. In the Rock I Hide.
Sir, I know you forgive us. You're from this hometown and you know we make mistakes because the mask give you trouble. Yes, so welcome, Senator. Welcome. We are happy to have you today. You're a friend of Sister Olive. Praise the Lord. So we are going to have now our tributes. Will be done by Life in Abundance, Sister Marcia, followed by the Moolah's family. Thank you very much. Praise the Lord. Could we worship the Lord? Could we worship the Lord? We are in Thanksgiving service, and she always tells me, my son was a deacon in church. I want you to come back. That's why I'm here to talk. My son was a deacon in church, pastor, but he allowed the devil to take him out. Well, we are going to allow God to pull him in today. Are you with me? Amen. We are going to give her her request. We are going to allow the Lord to pull him back, that he can go back and take up his position in the Lord. Okay? God bless you, Sister Marcio.
Praise the Lord. Glory to God. He's worthy to be praised. I've heard several persons talking about how Sister Olive loved to worship, and she wouldn't be sitting still in church, and she would have been up and down worshiping. And it's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. It's a good thing, you know, to call upon his name and to bless his holy name. This morning, I'm here, you know, to give a tribute on behalf of Life in Abundance, Jamaica. I met Sister Olive when we started the
combined the Faith Project group down here. She was a part of the group. And there are several things that I remember about Sister Olive, her gentle spirit. She has a little gentleness about her. She's quiet, soft-spoken, and gentle. Sometimes you hardly hear what Sister Olive says. And you know also her lisp. She has a little lisp, and when she talks, it sounds so sweet. But I remember going to Sister Olive on several occasions when I would go monitor and visit with the group. She was a part of the group, same group that Sister Elise was a part of, the Combined Faith Project. And sometimes we have missionaries here, visitors, and we would go and visit to see how, you know, she was going on, to encourage her in her project activity. And Sister Olive would, you know, show us the plants. She would have lovely plants around. And I realized that she has a green thumb and loves to take care of and tend her plants. But, you know, when she takes us to the coop and, you know, all that she has to do, we realize this little woman, she's little in body, but she's hardworking. I remember she planted sweet potato right at the side, at the front there. And the hard work that went into it. And, you know, I just wondered in my mind, how comes she had time to do so many things? Another thing that stood out to me was how she cared for her little granddaughter, Janae. She was a little at the time. And every, Janae, where are you, Janae? When sometimes we come and we say, where's Janae? Janae is sleeping. Sometimes Janae wakes up while we're outside talking or at the coop or in the garden or so. And Janae would wake up and come to the door and calling. I can't even picture her. No, I'm not seeing which one is her. Okay. That's little Janae. Yes. And she would come to the door and calling grandma. And she said, Janae, wait there, I'm coming, or something. You know, but she was always tender towards her. And she says sometimes, you know, she's sickly, so if it rained or so, she can't come outside and all of that. I remember that quite a bit. And, you know, just and understand how grandmas clock over the grandchildren. And then, you know, I know that because I'm a grandma as well. But Sister Olive, sweet, gentle soul. You know, I am so happy. You know, it is a different thing when one dies in the Lord. The atmosphere, the going home, the worship, it's different from when an unsaved died. And even when we mourn with tears and we cry, we know the eternal hope that she had. And so we know that she's not lost. So we don't mourn as though we don't have any hope. We mourn, we grieve, because Jesus Christ understood grief. He grieved when his friend Lazarus died. The word of God said Jesus wept. And so he knows crying, he knows pain. And he knows that when we lose a loved one, our hearts are broken. We grieve, we cry. But then we are encouraged because we know Sister Olive has gone home to be with the Lord. We know because of how she lived, the fruit, how she lived. I heard someone giving a remembrance, speaking about her sharing the gospel and with others, and she was a true missionary. We give God thanks for that. So this morning, I just want to extend my condolence on behalf of Life in Abundance to the family, immediate family, and to relatives, and to the church family and pastor. I know she always says, Sister Olive, my cousin, and we're going down to my cousin or something. She always talking about Sister Olive, her cousin. And so I extend condolence to you, to the pastor, and the entire church family. Let us remember Sister Olive as a child of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And let us too draw a pattern. If we don't know Christ, or if we have moved away, it is now time to return or to come to him. Today is the day of salvation. Tomorrow is not promised to us. And we don't know if we are going to see tomorrow. God bless you. Take heed. God bless you. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, Sister Marcia. I know. Thank you very much, Sister Marcia, the director for Life in Abundance, a strong woman, a woman of substance. She was here with Sister Ellis, Thanksgiving service. She's here again. She's a friend of the church. Thank you very much, Sister Marcia. Please still don't leave. We have to step back the mullahs. Sister Moore have to go to work. She's a pharmacist technician, and she asked for a few hours to be here. So we have to take the choir, a part of the choir of which Sister Olive was a member of the choir. So she wanted to do everything for Sister Olive before she go to work. So we're going to grant her this request at this time. We're going to have just a part of the choir to come and do a rendition for us. Then we have the mullahs. Put your hands together for them as they come. Look here, I don't want to thank you, clap, you know. Because she would clap well if it was you. Thank you very much.
Praise the Lord. So long I had searched for life meaning in
Worship the Lord. Let me hear the church worship the Lord. Save and unsaved, just wave your hand and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Good singing choir. Good singing. We have with us also Mrs. Needham from the Mandeville Fire Department. Yes, she is a part of the family as well. And so we welcome you, Mrs. Needham. Do you want a seat? She is one of the personal secretary. And we bless the Lord that she could take time off from her busy schedule to be here. Amen. We are going to continue with the program. At this time, we are going to have the mullahs to come forward with the tribute.
Greet you all in Jesus' name. And we are here to honor a life well lived, and in full agreement with what Sister Marcia Crawford, Life in Abundance Director, said. We worked closely and with her and got in touch with Sister Gloria at the same time. We detail what Sister Marcia has said. It captures the essence of a life well lived, a good balance of the heavenly and earthly life. She really captured the sustaining of a life from the heavenly dimension and the earthly dimension. And we mourn now, but with joy, in expectation to meet with her again. I'll let my dear wife and co-worker say a few words, and then we'll be seated. God bless you.
Our condolences to the family. Greetings to everyone. We thank God and all protocols of that. I will just say a few words concerning our sister Olive. Joseph and myself and our family came from Africa as missionaries and arrived this country on October 2009. And in 2010, we were privileged to be invited into this congregation by Pastor Balda, and we got to meet our husband, Bishop Bennett, and they became a dear family to us, and they introduced us to their congregations. In this congregation, we met Sister Olive. And as it is said, you can always hear so many things from so many people, and you will forget what they said. But you will never forget how a person made you feel. We have forgotten so many things that Sister Olive said, but we've never forgotten how Sister Olive made us feel in her presence. She made us feel welcomed, accepted, appreciated, and loved. And she encouraged us not by her words many times, but by her actions. Because when we had the combined faith project that we started together with faith, with the Life in Abundance, As a matter of fact, the person who was here first was Sister Olive. She came most times to open the doors and clean up and set up the seats. And do you know what that made us feel? It made us feel this: you are wanted. You are wanted. And we took note of that. Then at times we'd come and it's raining and there nobody turns up. But Sister Olive would be present. And she would come running and say, "I'm sorry." And she would explain where she was, but she turned up. What do you think that made us feel? Appreciated. She appreciated our efforts of coming to share what we had to share. So what can we say? We have forgotten so many things, as Sister Olive said, but we have not forgotten and will never forget how Sister Olive made us feel. And for that, we say, the Lord bless the family. And with that grace of blessing the families, people, especially people whom we don't know, they didn't know us much. We had come from Africa. They didn't know whether we came carrying what from Africa or what from Africa. But she had faith that we are people of God sent from Africa. And she was ready to listen to us with every given opportunity and share faith with us in Christ Jesus. So we are thankful for her life. And we pray for the family, for God's greater consolation that man cannot be able to give. We are here to condole and console the family. However, we are very sure that only God can fill up the gaps that man cannot fill. So that is our prayer, that God will hold you closer, tighter, and fill up every gap that you may feel, more than we do feel, and more than the church may feel. You may feel the greater gap. So we pray that the Lord will fill that gap and give you the grace in the process of grief, and will help you. God bless.
Thank you very much to Pastor Joseph and Sister Alice Mula. Thank you very much for that remembrance. They remember her in a special way. That's why my father always say, first impression lasting. So you see, she make a good impression when the Mulas came here, and they remember, out of everything, they remember that. So I want to remind us that good impression lasting. Amen? At this time, we are going to sing the offertory hymn, and I'm going to ask the ushers to do the offering for us. We are going to sing the offertory hymn, and I need you to help me sing. I'm not a good singer, so I'm going to ask you to help me sing this one. As I journey through this land.
As I journey through this land, singing as I go, pointing soul to Calvary, to that Prince of Glory. Many are resting my soul, but without waiting. Thank you.
when we can see the Lord face to face and see our dear beloved sister. Amen. I'm going to ask Minister Rob just to give thanks for the offering. And in that same breath as she's coming, I want to welcome Pastor Blackwood and his dear wife. They are also a member of the family, Hutchinson family, and we make them welcome at this time. Minister Rob.
Control. We thank you for the offering that has been accumulated today. We pray it will be so spent to the honor and glory of your name. And everyone who reach out, Lord, to give, we pray that you will multiply for them and supply their every need. And for those who need this have, Lord, we know that you're a God who knows how to provide for your people. We give you thanks, Father, and we hope that your mercy seed for the rest of the blessings. We wait and ask for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. We have to be out here by 10 minutes to 12. So at this time, we're going to have the eulogy, which will be done by Camille Allen's daughter and Jean Jones Sinclair's daughter. And we'll be having a selection from Sister Morrison. Then the next voice you'll hear is the voice of Bishop Neville Bennett, Justice of the Peace for the Parish of Manchester. So we take it in that form. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. We bless the Lord. We praise the name of Jesus. Praise God. God is good and his mercies endure it. Amen. The good Bible says that in all things we should give thanks. No matter what the circumstances, we should still give God thanks. Amen. Amen. Praise God. To everything there is a season, a time for every matter under the heavens. A time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to keep and a time to cast away. We are gathered here today in the memory of our mother, Gloria Hutchinson, so that together we may acknowledge and share both our joy in the gift that her life was to us and the pain that her passing brings. In sharing the joy and the pain together, today we may lessen the pain and remember more clearly the joy.
Eulogy for the late Gloria Anna Flora Hutchinson. Miss Olive. The late Gloria Anna Flora Hutchinson, affectionately called Miss Olive, was born on October 17, 1950, the first child for Lester Hutchinson and Merilda Gregory in Cocoawt District, Cross Keys, Manchester, where she grew up with her siblings, Wesley, Pauline, Roy, and her deceased brother, Pete. It was not until their mother passed away they were separated, but nonetheless, they still maintained close contact. Mm-hmm. Her formal education began at the New Broughton Infant and All-Age School, where she moved on to learn a trade at the Cross Keys Community Center. Through this endeavor, she met Juris Jones and moved to live in New Forest District. Jean and Jeffrey Jones was the product of this relationship. She subsequently moved to Maypen Clarendon, after which she met and married Denzel Salter in August 1983. That union produced another child, Camille Salter. Gloria, Mommy. She was an independent and resilient woman. She was also a businesswoman and was successful in whatever she puts her mind to. Mommy moved back to Manchester in 1998, where she operated a corner shop in Cocoawt and started to build her house. She was adamant to finish that house to make it a home for her children and grandchildren. Gloria got saved in the Church of God of Prophecy, Cross Keys, Manchester, where she was a devoted Christian and a member of the assembly. Gloria accepted assignments and was growing in the Lord. She was a hard-working and dedicated woman who would go the extra mile to give a helping hand, a very willing and caring person she was.
Amen.
It was after Hurricane Ivan, she lost everything at the corner shop, so she resorted to farming, goat rearing, and she raised chicken and other ground provisions. Mommy had a green thumb for everything she touches, especially her flowers garden. She had a special love for flowers. She had a special love for God and her family. She was a praying mother and a praying grandmother. She lifted her faith to God in every situation. My siblings and I could never ask for a better mother. You were God's choice for us, and so we are grateful that your dedication has provided all of us with an earthly picture of love. Mommy was also a tower of strength for her grandchildren, especially Janae, who she nurtured from birth. Today, Mommy, we bid you farewell.
We say thank you for all that you have done for us. But I believe you are saying to us that you have just left us for a while, and we should not grieve and hug our sorrows through the years, but that we should start out bravely with a smile. Therefore, still so many thoughts to share and so many memories to recall. She leaves to mourn sisters Pauline and Bev, brothers Wesley and Roy, children Jean, Jeffrey, and Camille, sons-in-law Peter and Andrew, grandchildren Jermaine, Jerome, Javian, Keanu, and Janae, nieces, nephews, and other relatives and church family and friends. Gone too soon. God knows best, but you will be in our hearts forever. We love you, Mommy.
You taught me everything, and everything you've given me, I always keep inside. You're the driving force of my life. Yeah, and there is anything or anyone that I can be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. There were so many times looking back when I was so afraid. And you said to me, I can face anything. And when you come to me,
sorry.
Mama.
Come back to share a short message with you all. But in doing so, I want to advance my greeting and recognition to some person I've missed earlier. I want to recognize Mr. Emmett Needham, who is the assistant superintendent, maybe now acting deputy superintendent for Jamaica Fire Brigade, Mandeville, and also Mrs. Needham, is their wife. Persons who have come to know over these years and have worked over the years with. There are some very great people. Also, Senator Skeffrey, who I missed earlier, later recognized him, and Sister Hines. But I do so with the understanding and courtesy that maybe I have made the mistake in not recognizing them. I know Sister Bennett has done some corrections there. But in doing this, I would love to speak from my heart in the short time I have left. But the Word of God is so important that we can't miss a beat without expressing some of it to you all in this forum. God's Word is here to guide us and to give us the sustenance that we need, especially in these times. There's no other book that can do this. Quite often we try with words otherwise to give comfort and strength. But I notice even the politicians, they still go back and to the scriptures. Sometimes you want to believe that some of them are real preachers. No pun intended, Mr. But the truth is, God's word is the foundation, it's the compass, is the chart, and everything is the foundation of all things for us. And not only because we are people in the Western world, but there's not a book that in this time can really, you can draw on to satisfy the needs of getting words that are solid and words that will sustain one in this time. Grief is so common in this time. I was reading the other day from Revelation, and the four horsemen of the apocalypse, the pale horse is one of those that the rider on the pale horse brings death. And certainly, he's on it, and the rider of the pale horse is going through. We have been into this kind of setting so often that my messages are more or less repetitive, because I had no choice other than to go back to the same words, the words of God. But in my brief remarks now, I want to look at Job chapter 14 and St. John chapter 11, one Old Testament and one New. Job, in his suffering, asks a question that is very pivotal to this time. Job chapter 14, verse 14. If a man die, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time, I will wait till my change come. In the Gospel of St. John, chapter 11, very famous for the time when Lazarus died and Jesus visited the home of the bereaved. It was one of the sisters who said, "Master, if you've been here, my brother would not die." But in verse 23, Jesus said unto her, "Thy brother shall live again." I want to use those two texts to put the basis of our subject here, celebrating hope, because Job, in his grief, suffering, asks the question, if a man die, shall he live again? And we all know why Job asked that question. He was overwhelmed with grief to the point that he cursed the days of his life. He wished that he would have the opportunity to speak to God personally. He said, "Oh, that my grief were written with an iron pen, That means they would be engraved forever into something. But for one thing he did not do, he did not charge God foolishly or curse him. And that really gave us a lesson to learn that despite the loss and everything else, let us not in our heart feel that God is unreasonable. Let us have hope and let's celebrate hope because he gave us hope. So I understand your feelings, Sister Camille, the rest of family members, I understand it. But I remember Sister Hutchinson briefly, she was just this utility person. She could be engaged in almost everything. And for one reason or another, she could be relied on without fear of disappointment in any task that she was given to do. And she had lived her life within the confines of God's word to say that there is hope in God and there is a faith that I have in God and I want to live so that my work would be counted. And I'm glad that I want to believe that God has counted her work. And that she would be advancing in the kingdom of God to eternal life. Can we praise the Lord in the house? Back to this in a short while I close. Job's example is to all of us. For God boasts of his integrity in Job. God challenged the devil that he will never let him down. I hope the Lord can say some of the good things like that about us today. Can we praise the Lord? And indeed, to the very end, Job held on to his integrity. That even though his wife said, if you curse God and die, give up man, you are suffering. That was wrong counsel. Job's remark was, you speak like one of the most foolish women ever seen. And then he go on to bear his infirmity. In chapter 14, Job asks the question, which is pivotal to everyone who suffers. And everyone who will come under the penalty of any adversity will feel the pangs of pain and no flesh really welcomes it. And all of us at that sometime or other will die because the last enemy that shall be destroyed, death. Death is common to all of us. There's none of us that when death comes can say, I put you off for another time. I change my appointment with you. Because the word of God says, he's appointed unto man once to die. And after death, the judgment. So in verse 14, Job really asks the question because he feels pain. And he knows why it is. But I notice in chapter 19, it was the same Job who said, I know that my Redeemer lives. That is hope. Because when he was going through suffering, he had a downtime in his life. Yes, we all come to that position sometimes. There are downtimes in our life when we feel, Lord, I can't go through this. I can't make it through another day. I am going through too much. No wonder some of us copy the remark and say, God, I'm not Job sometimes. Well, every one of us has to be like him for us to please God. But God boasts of his integrity and he held on to his integrity. So in chapter 19, he made the remark, I know my Redeemer lives and I will stand with him at the latter day upon the earth. And he said further, after what? Worm, this straw, this body, yet in my flesh, what makes him say all of that is hope? With the understanding that yes, a grave is prepared for me. Yes, this flesh will perish and decompose and go back to the ground as God said. Yes, but my spirit will live and I will be vindicated because death will never have power over me forever. So there is hope in God. And I want the family members who are now grieving to understand when we say this, we are not just trying to make a story up. It is the true word of God. Because when I go to St. John's Gospel, in that same verse that I read, Mary take on Jesus and say, Lord, if you were here, remember we called you 4 days earlier. I'm paraphrasing. You didn't come. But if you were here, I know my brother wouldn't die. Because I saw you raise the dead before. I saw you heal the sick before. I saw you work miracles before. So why we call is because we need you then. But Jesus looked at Mary in the face, no wonder, and said, your brother. Can I say this to the family member? Your mother, your family member shall live again. Praise God. And you can take Jesus' word night or day, anytime. Because if Jesus says so, oh Lord, help me here. I saw you go for truth. If Jesus said, I'm coming to your home to raise your daughter, Jairus, I saw it go for true. If Jesus stopped the procession outside of me and touched the ear of the casket of a young man inside and the widow was over him weeping, yes, I saw it happen for true. So what do you say that your mother will live again? You can take it to the bank, you can take it to the supermarket, you can take it with your entire life. That the words of Jesus are true. And I close with Revelation chapter 21, because John was thrown out of society on an island named Patmos because of his faith. And the Lord visited him and said, John, come up higher and write this. Oh, come up higher, John, and write this. Amen. And he wrote so many things of what happened after, what happened before, what happened present, and so on and so on. But in chapter 21, and in chapter 20, and verse 6, it said, blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection. For upon them the second death has no power. Can we bless the Lord for that? It simply tells me that men will exit this life, move on. But if they have part in the first resurrection, amen. The second death, which is the everlasting one, has no power. The first one is this one, where she is absent in body. A picture is there to indicate that Sister Olive, all right, wearing on a very infectious smile all her life. She's not here in body, but in spirit with the Lord. Well, I like verse 14 and verse 13, which said, I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, John, write. Take it back to the living. Take it back to the churches out there in Asia Minor. Write this down and let them know that blessed are the dead. Come on, church. I know you're in mourning. I know somebody is in grief. But blessed. The word blessed means secure. The word blessed means happy. The word blessed means assurance. The word blessed means peaceful. Blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. From henceforth, said the Spirit, they will what? Rest. They will rest from church work. They will rest from domestic work. They will rest from any other thing that they were doing. And their works do follow them. So, I'm saying to those who are alive here today, be assured, celebrate hope. Celebrate hope, because the hope in the Lord. That the book of God said, if in this life only we have hope, we are what? Of men most miserable. We will be miserable over a lot of things that does not please God. But if our life please God, he said, precious in the sight of God. Oh my God, help us. Is the death of the saints. But I have no pleasure in the death of a sinner. But to God there is pleasure in the death of the righteous. So God wants us to be righteous. Amen. That's my last word to those outside of God and Christ who don't know him yet. You must crave and endure and strive to be righteous. Because if you die righteous, you will get that race. If you die outside of that premise, oh, it's a dark future for you. But I trust and hope your persons inside here will hear this word and adhere to the word of God as it speaks. Blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. From henceforth to the spirit there is some the labor and the work will follow them. The good works of her life will follow her into the kingdom. But the bad works of the evil man go on to wait on them. You know, I heard that first time at a little graveside talk. You know, when you go to a graveside, you hear a lot of talk. And a gentleman came up to me and said, Pastor, you know what? A man that do good works follow him. Yes. But a person who do bad works, he gone on, God wait on him. Yes. Say, what do you mean? At first it sounds foolish, but I think about it over and over. I said, you know, you could be probably right. You'd be probably right. Because if a man keep doing wrong things, it ensures your destiny of going to a Christless eternity. But if you do good things, amen. That's what the word of God says, goodness and mercy. Come on. Minister of my life, what the psalm said. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I thank you for listening to me in this short message. God bless your heart.
Praise the Lord. Could you worship the Lord? Great words, strong words. Words of wisdom, words of life. God bless you, Bishop Bennett, for this wonderful word. And at this time is really slipping away from us. I don't have time to comment on it, but the same God said to Mary, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. So the resurrector is here today to give somebody's life. So if you need prayer, I just want to raise your hand. As Minister Rob will be praying for the family members. So anyone else need prayer, just indicate by raising your hand. Anyone else? Thank you very much. I'm going to ask the family members to remain seated and the rest of persons to stand with us as we pray for the family members. God bless you, Bishop Bennett. A job well done. You always do us justice and justice to the word of God. God bless you.
Our kind, righteous Heavenly Father, we give honor and glory to you, Lord, for your goodness and your mercy towards us. Lord, we thank you for this beautiful day that you have given unto us. I know that there are many hearts today, Lord, who are filled with sorrow, but yet there is joy because we have been encouraged to know, Lord, that you know to do everything. You does everything best. And our beloved sister whom you have taken away from us, Lord, we are so grateful to know that we can testify of the life she lives. And we've been encouraged to know that one day we will be with her in glory. I pray today for the family members. Oh God, the children and the sisters and brothers and nieces and nephews, every member of the family today. We ask of you to give them strength, give them courage. Help them, Lord, that they will not be utterly dismayed, but that their spirit will become strong, knowing, God, that it would not be the way she wants it to be. It is that she would love them to pursue righteousness. She would love them to pursue after holiness, because that was her deal, that was her life, that was what she did. And we pray today, Lord, for the members of the family who are not saved. God, we are asking for your divine love to be entering into their hearts. We do not know whether today or tomorrow, when we shall come, because we all have an appointment with death. And he didn't tell us the day, the time, or the hour when he shall call us. But one thing we are assured, that death is an appointment. And we pray today, O God, that every heart that is in here have listened to your words. Lord, we pray that something will reside within the heart, knowing, Father, that we live for Christ, we live forever. We don't live for him, we are living in vain. And there are so many today, Lord, even those who have once tasted of your love and have forgotten, I pray to bring them back. Let them allow the death of Sister Olive to be beginning of life for them, because they too can return to the Lord. And knowing, Father, the only way that we shall have union with her again is when their lives is also given to Christ, that they serve him in spirit and in truth. And so we pray today, Holy Father, please to control every member of the family. Oh God, Sister Camille will be going back into the very home. Lord, I pray, God, for extra strength. Cover her over, Lord, under the blood. Help her that as she stand, Lord, oh God, or as they stand, and having done all to stand. Help her to rely on you. Help her to trust in you. Help her to find herself hiding in your bosom, oh God. Because memories will be all over. Every time she turns, she will have a memory. But in the name of Jesus, I pray to help her to remember that, God, you have taken away this sting, and there is joy in the Lord. Oh, God, give her a song in her heart. Give her that hope, oh, God. The Bible tells us we should hope now in God. And so I pray for my sister today. Give her that strength, Lord, that resilience within her to say, one day I will meet my mama and I will just live for God, live in holiness, live a life of righteousness. I will never be dismayed. Help her, Lord, that she will understand that there is nothing that we can change. So we have to learn to accept the things that we cannot change. Bless the rest of the family today, Lord, and lead us everyone to victory. For those who raise their hand for prayer, you know their reason. You know their purpose. I pray for a fresh supply today, Father. We are leaving here, Lord, to go to the last leg of this commitment. I pray for your eternal presence. Oh, God, I know it is very painful. It is a very sore thing. God, many of us have been through it, and we know what it is like. But we pray today for your divine angels to go before us, oh God, and call that when we have finished today, it will be joy unspeakable and full of glory. We honor you, Father, and give you the praise and give you the glory and give you all the honor that is due to your name. As we lean upon your unchanging hand for the blessings, we humbly ask and beg it all by faith receiving in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Minister Rob. Thank you very much. We are going to sing the offertory hymn before that Bishop Bennett will be giving the instruction. But I want to do the vote of thanks on behalf of Sister Camille. The recessional hymn. But I just want to do the vote of thanks on behalf of Sister Camille. I would like to say thanks to all who supported us and show love during this difficult time. A special thanks to Uncle Roy, Uncle Wesley, Auntie Bev, Auntie Pauline, to my immediate family members, my extended family, and to in-laws, Mr. and Mrs. Allen, Miss Lawrence, and Auntie Jen, for never leaving our side. Thanks to Pastor Bennett, Bishop Bennett, Minister Rob, Sister Wisdom, Brother and Sister Myra, Sister Michelle, Henry. I really appreciate the support that was given. A huge thank you to Bishop Anderson of the Sandy Bay IEM Church and Reverend Dwayne Johnson for hosting our Zoom prayer meeting. Special thanks to those who helped out at the grave digging and to all those who are here today. Thank you very, very much. God bless you. Bishop Bennett is going to give the instruction and then we take the recession in here.
Okay, thank you, Pastor Bennett. The instruction is very simple. We'll be leaving here to the family block. We go across the square and turn left, going down the high school. So we proceed further down. It's not far. But at the same time, I must be guided that the protocols of the COVID says it's not all that crowd of people should go. I know it's going to be difficult for me to convey that. However, I must tell you the truth. It should be 15 people going with the family members, including the clergy. Now, when people maybe lined up there already, it's not an easy thing to manage. But that's the guidance that we have. And I hope we can go in order using one side of the road, which is the left side in Jamaica. Now, I'm going to ask you as much as possible. Could I thank the videographers today? I didn't remember them and the musicians. To adhere to this simple procession, we want order and we want safety. Okay? This memorial service is live on YouTube, so if that is the case, I hope we have done some things right and you can watch it later if it's still there. Could we stand? We're going to sing just one or maybe two verses of the song as we prepare to leave out. If I walk in the path of duty, if I work to the close of the day, I shall see the great King's beauty when I have gone the last mile of the way. And we take up our positions. Please allow me to go before the hearse. And then the rest of us will proceed along with family members behind the hearse itself. If I walk in the pathway of duty, if I work to the close of the day, I shall see the great King's beauty when I walk the last mile of the way. When I
if you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees, and lend a voice to those who cannot speak. If you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way. There's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes
right, people, we are transitioning to the burial further down in Cross Keys, so please stay tuned. Down there? You're good?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. When your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Family members, sick. We are giving you a privilege. So just take a shot, take a shot, take a shot. Take a shot. Just go stand and stare. And in fact, it just be the family. We're not hard, we're trying to do what is best for everybody. So, while the camera, videographers, those who have reached the period of just to just have them in place, we're going to move on. And we are going to fill out your corporation, infinity. All right, thank you very much.
Banderas, Banderas, please.
Could you cut off the music for me, Mr. Undertaker?
David!
Cut the music for me. Somebody just cut off the music. One of the... Workmen just continue to mix up what you have.
Paul Bearers!
Roy Hutchinson, Jeffrey Jones, son, Andrew Allen, son-in-law, Peter Sinclair, Jayman Joseph, Jerome Jones, Javian Denton, any of those amounts, just, yeah, man, you'd have to go back.
Yeah, go back that way,
move. Just take it safe, though, take it safe.
Hello, Jerry.
Nobody's stumbling, just take it safe. How if you want?
Well, Jerry,
whether you want to come this side, which is easier.
This side look easier.
Less perilous. Come this side. Just a little. All right. And while you are at a distance, I hope you can still engage us. You have a lot of singing to do. But we have to do what we have to do.
Take your time
and come forward.
Take your time. Watch your step.
Try don't stumble. Come around, make a turn.
Come see him here. Stretch out, go side. These men over have to come round here and come over. So you're not going to hear them yet, come round.
You come on.
Hold it.
Come now.
Go on.
Find one, you know.
Rest.
Come on,
all right, take your time.
All right.
For your engagement, for those who are a little nearer to me, those who are finished, what we have to do. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Neither does corruption inherit corruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in a moment in the twinkling of an eye. At the last trump, and the dead in Christ shall raise incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality. So when this corruptible have put on incorruption, and this mortal put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying which is, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? But thanks be to God that gave us the victory to our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abound in the work of the Lord. Wherefore, for as much as we know that your labor in him is not in vain, that building. Could you just spin that? Can spin this. For as it pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world unto himself the soul of our deceased sister, we therefore commit her body to the ground. earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. From henceforth said the Spirit, that they will rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Will you bow your heads and make a big benediction? Almighty God, in your wise providence and mercy, you have upheld our sister in life through her ups and her downs. Lord, she's no more with us in the flesh, but we believe, Lord, she's with you in spirit. We make this proclamation, mighty God, against your word, which this says, that man will go back to the dust as it was. Today, Lord, thy word has come to pass, and that has been fulfilled. All our records are with you, and we know, Lord, that you are the final arbiter over all of us. Whatever her works may be, they are in your hands. We thank you for her life while she was living. We give you praise as the Almighty One who has dominion and power over all things. In Jesus' name, we say amen. Together, we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. While the workmen are preparing to close up this vault, we are going to sing When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. Those of you who have the program from near to far, the distance, we are still going to sing this, and the workmen will be closing up quickly. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the same of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll, everybody, raise your voice. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On a bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, can leave some for it. And the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and hardly hear no much people. Life is over and our work on earth is done.
and the roll is called of yonder there. When the roll is yonder, when the roll is called of yonder, it's called up yonder. When the roll is called up yonder, hallelujah, oh yes. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, yes, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, yes, there's still another hymn. There's a land that is
not a time for the blessing of rest in the sweet by and by. There we shall meet on the beautiful shore in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore,
to a bountiful Father,
to a bountiful Father above,
we shall offer tribute.
We will offer a tribute of praise
for the glorious gift of His love,
for the glorious gift of His love,
and the blessing that hallowed our day,
and the blessing that hallowed our day. In the sweet by and by,
we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In that sweet by and by,
we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Take the last verse over.
In the bountiful Father above, we will offer the tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love
and the blessing that hallowed our days.
And the blessing that hallowed our days. In that sweet by God, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In that sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Oh, in that sweet
by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In that sweet by and by, on that beautiful shore.
Praise the Lord. That's a hopeful song.
Yes.
That's a hopeful song.
Indeed.
Amen. Some choruses are on the program. Can we take a few?
Yes.
And the workmen will just finishing up. Meet me by the river. Shall we? We shall have a grand time. Better days are coming if you miss me. Any one of the four.
By the river,
sing together. All right, go ahead, sister.
By the river, someday.
Meet me by the river, not far away. Oh, when the Lord shall call me home, happy, happy home beyond the sky. Meet me by the river someday. Oh, meet me by the river someday. Meet me by the river, Lord, far away. When the Lord shall call me home, happy, happy home beyond the sky. Meet me by the river someday.
Oh,
by the river. Come here. Meet me by the river. Not far away. When the Lord shall call you home. Happy, happy home, me on the sky. Meet me by the river. Someday. Oh, meet me by the river.
We shall have a grand time. Up in heaven. We shall have a grand time. Up in heaven. Have a grand time. Walking with the angels.
Hallelujah.
We shall have a grand time. Up in heaven. Have a grand time. Oh, we shall have a grand time. Up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time. Oh, walking with the angels,
sing glory, hallelujah.
We shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time. Oh, we shall have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time. Walking with the angels, glory, hallelujah. We shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time. One more time. We shall have a grand time up in heaven. We shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time. Walking with the angels,
sing glory, hallelujah. Oh, we shall have a grand time up in heaven, have a grand time.
Better days are coming.
Better days are coming.
When we meet to
sit
in the sky, sorrow will be over. Joy will come at last. Better days are coming by and by.
Better days are coming by and by. When we reach the city in the sky,
sorrow will be over. Joy will come at last. Better days are coming by and by.
By and by.
When we reach the city
in the sky, sorrow will be
over and joy will come at last.
Better days are coming by and
by. Oh, better days are coming by and by. When we reach a city in the
come knocking on my door. I'm because in the twinkling.
don't find me, you know that I'm gone. And if you don't hear from me,
don't come knocking at my door. I'll be gone in the twinkling of an eye. My father is a millionaire. I'm sitting on the floor. My father is a millionaire. I'm stepping on gold.
Each step I take,
I'm stepping on gold. I'm stepping on gold. My father is a millionaire. I'm stepping on gold. My father is a millionaire. I'm stepping on gold. Each step I take.
Thank you very much, workmen. Thank you all, people. Thank you, everyone who have cooperated to this point. We're going to do a final prayer and then consider ourselves dismissed. So I'm going to ask you to bow your heads and we do this prayer together. Yes, Lord, we thank you at this juncture. We have reached this point where you help us to carry through this process. We're going to give you thanks with a heart of gratitude for strength and the ability. We thank you for all the cooperation we receive from everyone. And as we consider ourselves dismissed from here, we pray you'll go with us and be with us. Give us the guidance we need for the rest of the day. And to, oh God, even the provisions we made for the refreshment, we ask your blessing upon it. And this we ask as a favor from you. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, I'm told that refreshment is served just at this shop right here. At Mr. Williams' shop. So if that is there, you can go and refresh yourself. And I want to thank everyone today who have come. I want to also read the acknowledgement on this, which says, the family of the late Gloria Hutchinson, Miss Olive, wishes to express thanks to all who have showed and expressed care and concern during our time of bereavement. We appreciate all the words of encouragement, visits, calls, and other demonstration of love extended to us during this time. We are truly grateful. And I already give my thanks to the workmen, videographers, and everyone. The Lord bless you. At the end of this, though, I have some very sad news that relates to Crosby's Church. That the Brother Beckford has lost his wife. That's Brother Beckford, a member of Crosskey's Church, has lost his wife. Blacker. Everybody know Blacker. He has lost his wife, so there's another family in mourning. We want to convey our condolences to them and hope that they will get comfort and strength. All right. That is it for us. Amen.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break,
if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way,
There's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. The streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. There's a place up there for people like you.